you very much for coming. Do not forget, please, to turn off your mobile phones. The first thing you should do. Thank you. Next to me, Dasha Yanitskaya. She will tell you a few things about the project you will see tonight. This is her, I think, fourth project as a director.
Yeah.
So correct this time. And unfortunately, her last one, because she's graduating, and hopefully she will continue.
No. They're not going to get me then.
It looks she's here for eternity, even being away for one year in Norway. So thank you very much for coming, Dasha.
Thank you so much for being here today. I know it's a very busy week. The play that I'm presenting today is a farce. It's a comedy by Dave Freeman. It's a British farce, and it's called Bedfull of Foreigners. It's a story about the hotel where you probably wouldn't want to be in, with the people you wouldn't want to be in together with. Or maybe you would. Let's see and check it out. There will be an intermission between the acts. You're very welcome to go upstairs and have some homemade wine with us. Thank you so much. Enjoy the play.
Stayed here before. Listen. Is water going down plug hole? You happy? Good. I'm saving room for you. Au revoir, monsieur.
That's marvelous.
Oh, it's good, yeah?
The hotel full, the village festival, an important guest arriving, and you're just drinking.
You want me downstairs drinking?
I don't want you drinking anywhere. I want you working.
So I'm working. I'm mending bed light.
Hurry up and finish it. I've just received a telegram. Mrs. Hofmeyer is arriving.
So who in hell is Mrs. Hofmeyer?
The president of the Bulgarian Bicycle Cycling Club.
Oh, it's good, yeah?
I'm trying to get the hotel placed on their approved list. It's very, very important for us. The tiniest complaint, the least thing wrong, and we're struck off their list forever.
So, where are you sticking her?
I am accommodating her in that room next door to her, and I want everything in that room working properly. I want everything perfect.
So how can room be perfect when hotel is falling to bits?
Don't talk rubbish.
It's falling to bits, I'm telling you. It's all rotten and full of woodworm. Attacking it.
Impossible.
Why impossible?
Because, Karak, that cuckoo is plastic and woodworm do not eat plastic.
What's that?
It's he who must not be named.
It's that radiator. I thought the plumber came to look at it.
Yeah, plumber took a look at it and plumber is recommending you buy a new one.
A new radiator?
No, a new hotel.
Haha, very funny. I'm not concerned with what the plumber thinks. I am concerned with Mrs. Hofmeyer, and it's very important. She finds nothing wrong.
Yeah.
Furthermore, I mentioned in the letter that here we speak Bulgarian.
Oh, I didn't know you speak Bulgarian.
Not me, idiot, you.
Me?
You told me once you were Bulgarian.
Never, I told you I was Hungarian.
Oh, so now you are Hungarian.
No, it's just what I'm telling you.
Where the hell are you from?
I'm from foreign Legion. Legion is giving me pension. Making me French citizen.
What were you before you joined that legion?
Before I joined, I was a foreigner. You see, if you're not a foreigner, they don't bloody want you.
Well, I don't want you either.
Ah, but you see, you are inheriting me along with hotel. Your aunt said I was to be kept as concierge as long as I'm wishing.
Listen, I don't have time to argue with you. The moment you're down here, go downstairs and relieve Marcel at reception.
He is up in his room being sick.
Sick?
It's something he ate at a restaurant.
Our restaurant? What did he eat?
Our chef special, same as guests.
And this guest. Oh God. Who's down at reception?
Nobody. I'm putting outside calls to telephone up here. What are you doing?
Calling the ambulance! Don't you realize, Narak? Those people who ate the chef's special could be sick, the entire hotel! Allô? Ici Hotel 9? Nous avons un rendez-vous dans l'hôtel?
In that case, you're needing more than one ambulance. You're needing four, perhaps six.
Will you shut up? Pardon, monsieur. Mm-hmm. No, no. Bon. Au revoir, monsieur. Nobody must know about this. If Mrs. Popmeyer finds out, I'm finished.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to the room now to check the lights.
Make sure you lock that door behind you. And Karak, see she has everything she wants.
Yeah, everything she wants. Excepting chef special.
Quiet, you!
He's good! I'm putting Big Bucket by her bed.
Yeah, but he left us when I was just 6 months old.
No wonder.
Excuse me.
next week is November. In 8 weeks, it's gonna be Christmas.
Yes, and whose idea was that we got here in October? Who said the weather is gonna be nice and we're not gonna have any problems getting the room?
Well, we didn't, did we? Until today?
And where we are today? In a refrigerator dormitory with a Black Death raging all around.
Oh, it's Black Death now, is it?
I think we should bring him.
Oh, just wait. A man with a card will be around any second, yelling, "Bring out your dad!" He'll give us a ride.
Where's our suitcase?
Well, I think he put it in the wardrobe.
What is his jack doing here?
Oh, I think he jammed it in when you were out of the window, ambulance spotting.
Well, so you remember it was your idea that we stay here. Oh my god.
What?
That door.
What about it? It's locked.
It's covered in wallpaper.
So what?
It reminded me of something.
Oh, that? Don't worry. As soon as we get back, I'll do the bloody bathroom out.
So long at the fair.
I beg your pardon?
The film I saw. It was about an English couple. They stayed in a hotel in Paris. She went for a walk, and when she came back, he'd vanished.
Vanished?
Yes. And they said they didn't even see her before. They said she didn't even stay there.
Well, did she?
Well, of course she did. She even tried to show them the room where she stayed, but the door was not there.
Well, where was it?
It was covered in wallpaper.
Well, I guess they did it to save paint.
Oh, they didn't do it to save paint.
Well, why did they do it then?
You bony Blake.
My God, listen, we're not going to have this conversation, and we're not leaving this hotel. I'm gonna go take a shower. It's not too warm in here, is it?
Glad your radar doesn't work.
Well, I'll tell him about it when he comes back.
What was he doing? Walking like that in his shirt sleeves?
Isn't it obvious? He's gone wallpapering. He's probably with a bucket of paste there. Don't worry, Professor. The world shall never hear our secrets. We shall wallpaper them in.
Wallpaper who in?
Oh, nobody. I mean, we were just talking about an old film we saw. She'll tell you about it.
Yeah, that one was about an English couple. They stayed in Paris during the Great Exhibition.
Oh, yes?
The hotel had bubonic plague.
Plague?
Yes, and they covered the door in wallpaper.
Wallpaper?
Yes, the same as the door over there. And what were those ambulances?
Well, one gets a very false impression about life in other countries from the cinema.
That's one.
Yes. For example, last night on television I was watching an old German musical.
Getting back to what we were saying.
On the other hand, that musical had some rather nice songs in it. I'm trying to remember how those songs went.
They went in two ambulances.
No. The song to the picture. Oh, yes. One of them is coming back to me. It was partly in English.
Von ganzen die Blumen in Sofa, von ganzen die Rosen on you. Of all the flowers I see on display, Rose of Beth is you.
That's quite nice.
Rosie, ich liebe dich viel zu viel. At the medical school, I was a member of the Amateur Operating Society.
Oh, you're a doctor?
Not exactly, but I was a medical student for 9 years.
That's a very long course, isn't it?
Not if you can pass the exams. My aunt was supporting me until she passed away.
Oh, I am so sorry.
So am I. It means now I have to run this hotel.
Well, I think the medical knowledge must come in very handy, especially when you have an epidemic.
We do not have an epidemic.
Why those ambulances?
Merely a minor case of food poisoning.
What did you
do then? A merely precaution. You see, with Mrs. Hoffmeyer arriving, I thought if those people are going to be ill, it's much better they're ill in the hospital, where she cannot see them.
No, for a moment I was very worried.
I could see you were. You know, you're very lovely.
Thank you.
You remind me so much of someone I once loved.
I am married.
So was she.
My husband is here.
It was hers.
He's right there, in the bathroom.
You're radiant, you're adorable. You're the loveliest woman I've ever met. Am I offending you by saying all this?
Yes. Well, I don't know, but he can come out at any second.
Then order me to leave. The moment I offend you, order me to leave.
Because what about the radiator?
Oh, I forgot.
Well, that's a fat lot of good. And what about those people?
People?
The ones who live in the
Oh, that was nothing.
Nothing?
They've just eaten something.
By the look of this place, I would have said it was a frostbite.
No, just a minor case of poisoning.
Why are you using your telephone voice?
He made a pass at me.
Who did?
The manager. Well, he didn't really make a pass at me.
Well, did he or didn't he?
He said I was radiant. He said I was the loveliest woman he ever had seen here.
Well, you know why he said that, don't you?
Why?
So you wouldn't ask him about the bloody radiator, that's why.
Well, if that's all you think of me.
Those foreigners are all the same, full of chat. I mean, it's not to worry you, darling.
I was not worried.
Good. He didn't try to pinch you behind, did he?
No, he didn't.
Good. Then he was just laying an old chat. Oh, my ear.
What's wrong?
I've got water in my ear. It keeps making those woom-woom noises.
Well, it's wet. You ought to get it searched.
Yes, I know that. Yes. But where?
Well, I suppose he could do it for you.
Who?
The manager.
The manager?
Yeah, he's some sort of doctor. Nearly.
Nearly.
I'm not sure if he actually practiced.
Well, he's not practicing on me. What else does he do?
He sings.
Sings?
Yes. He was singing a song out of an old silent film.
Well, that must have been hard.
Well, maybe it wasn't a silent film, maybe it was an early talkie, but anyway, I think he would look at your ear.
Oh, I bet he would if he could, but he's not bloody well going to. It's all right. I mean, if it goes off again, we'll call for him. The hotel manager sings up the ladies while he syringes and fleets of ambulances carry his successful cases.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
What?
Ah! It's gone! It's gone!
What has?
The ring my mother gave me! It's gone!
Oh, it's him! He's had it! The manager!
Oh, don't be so stupid!
No, but obviously it's him!
Let me think. It was that filling station. I went for a quick wash. Took it off and put it on the top of the wash basin.
But that was hours ago, before we stopped for tea.
Yeah, but then I got lost and we were going round and round in circles.
That was 4 miles ago, away. And I don't even remember the road.
I think I remember. Oh my God. I am so sorry. I'm sorry. I feel so bad. Oh my God, you're so sweet.
Yes, it's all right.
Other men would scream and shout.
Done is done.
Think of it. You've been driving all this way today, and now you'll have to drive all the way back. Don't worry. I'll drive a part of the way.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will.
No, you won't.
Why?
Because we're not bloody well going back, that's why.
Not going back?
Do you really think that the diamond ring left in the ladies' lavatory is still going to be there?
Yes. Oh, maybe. Anyways, we should go and see.
We're not going there. I don't even remember the road. And we'll get lost again.
No, we won't.
We got lost in the broad daylight. What chance do we have at night? And even if we do find it, it'll probably be closed.
It can be an oil like a rush.
Look, I'll buy you another one for Christmas.
I want another one. I want that one. And what is my mother going to say when I tell her I lost the ring my father gave me?
Don't tell her. It wasn't all that valuable, was it?
You don't care.
Well, of course I care.
Oh, you just don't care.
Of course I care.
You don't care about anything. You don't care that they're carrying people out of here on stretchers. You don't care that the manager tried to rape me.
He tried to what?
You don't care that our bathroom is like a pigsty. You won't do it up.
He tried to what?
to be avoided being rammed by a lunatic in a Mercedes doing 90 miles an hour on the wrong side of the road.
He was not on the wrong side of the road. You were.
Well, maybe I was, but I'm British. It takes time to get used to right-hand driving.
He stopped and offered to tow you out.
Oh, that was a fat load of good. He didn't have the rope.
And neither did you.
Well, no. But I have one now. If we get stuck again, I'll tow myself out.
I'm off.
No, you can't go, Brenda. Put that suitcase down.
No!
This is more important than losing some cheap golden tannery.
Oh, I haven't lost that. I still have the engagement ring that you gave me. And you can have it back!
Ow, hurt. You can't break off our engagement. We've been married for 9 years. You can't leave. I have the car keys.
No, you don't.
Oh, Brenda, where?
Yeah, he telephoned me and made reservations.
Oh, I see. But the room is so large.
Yeah, and it is the only one we have left.
Oh.
And anyway, you are two peoples. You are needing a large room.
But you see, he's not expecting you.
Ah, so you are surprising him?
Yeah, anyway, I was visiting my sister in Heidelberg, but then he had to say he was coming here on business. And then I remembered that tonight is his birthday. Why would he be here all on his own? So
it will be a nice surprise for him, yeah?
Yeah.
And it's a good thing we are saving you such a large room.
But then mind you, I'd be happy if it wasn't so large and slightly warmer.
Ah, wait. Oh, radiators is not switched on.
Why, why is that?
Who is knowing? Whole hotel is in state of panic.
Yeah, so it seems. Who was that man rushing out as I came in?
Plumber is leaving.
Plumber? Well, if he was a plumber, why was he in such a hurry? I thought the hotel was on fire.
Not yet. All we are having right now is food poisoning.
Food poisoning?
Is nothing.
That could be extremely serious. How many people are in the hotel?
Is nobody in the hotel?
Good.
Is all going to hospital. Manager is getting wind up. He's sending everybody who ate in the restaurant to hospital. He's idiot.
Oh no, I think he's very sensible. I remember when I was nursing in England.
Ah, you were nursing in England?
Yeah, I was a staff nurse. Mm. Is that radiator working now?
It's only little water squirting out hole, but it should be fine.
You mean it's leaking?
Don't worry. In 1/2 hour, room will be warm.
You know, I think I should take a hot bath.
You are wanting breakfast in the room?
No, thank you.
We are serving English breakfast. Eggs, bacon, and bunkers.
What is bunkers?
You are English, no?
No, I'm German. My husband's English.
Bunkers is worse.
Worse than what?
I'm speaking German now, it's worse.
Oh, you mean it's worse in English?
Bunkers is worse in German.
Ah, you mean worse sausage?
Yeah, sausage.
Of course, bangers. I'm sorry, I had forgotten.
You're not eating them in England now?
No. I don't live in England now. My husband works over here.
Whole Europe is full of foreigners, all living in wrong countries.
Where did you learn the English?
In Legion? People's here is friendly, but town is dirty. It is full of crookery.
Oh, you mean criminals?
No, crookery. Cups, saucers.
Crookery.
Is what I'm saying. But you being German, you are speaking with German accent.
Oh, let us. You, of course, speak perfect English.
Yeah, although I'm not actually Englishman.
Ooh. You surprise me.
Yeah.
What are you?
Laplander.
Laplander?
Yeah, but reindeer is all dying, so I'm coming here to follow. So, is there anything else you're wanting?
Oh, no, thank you, and here's something for you.
Ooh, danke schön, спасибо, женщина.
Let's hope the bottle is hot.
assure you.
I hope so, for your sake.
But it was. She was watching a rather unusual film about an exhibition in Paris.
My wife doesn't watch that sort of movies.
No, you were watching it as well. When I came in, you were discussing it, about wallpapering a door.
Oh, that one, yes.
Yeah, and then I went on to discuss the German film where the German man falls in love with the English girl.
And she thought you were making love to her.
Exactly, this is precisely what happened. This is absolutely correct.
Is that the best explanation you have?
For the moment, yes. If you're unhappy, all I can suggest is you leave the hotel.
Oh, I should very much like to.
There'll be absolutely no charge.
What for?
For anything.
I didn't have anything, but I don't know about you.
But I'm not charging you anything.
I should very well hope not.
So you wish to leave?
I can't. My wife drove off and left me here.
Where has she gone?
To the ladies' lavatory, 4 miles away.
That's ridiculous. We have plenty in the hotel.
To find the ring!
Well, I'm quite happy to drop the matter if you are.
For the moment, yes. We shall continue this conversation when my wife comes back. If she comes back.
Is there anything else I can do for you, sir?
My trousers are wet.
Your trousers are wet?
Yes, they're soaking. The bed's wet, too.
What have you done?
Have a feel!
Yeah. It's wet. Somebody's wetting it.
I think he'll come around the headquarters.
You mean he slept in this bed?
No.
He's a lunatic.
Maybe he was throwing water over it or something.
Let's hope it was just water.
I'm gonna call the chambermaid and... Oh, lieber Gott, I forgot you went to bed early. Don't worry, I think she's half asleep. She'll be here instantly in 5 seconds.
The radiator is leaking! The radiator is leaking!
Oh, what a hotel!
And don't forget the chambermaid.
Oh,
good evening.
Good evening. It's the radiator.
Yes, I know that. Sorry if we got you out of bed.
Oh, no. I wasn't in bed. I was taking a shower.
Oh, were you?
Yeah, I mind. I could have taken one standing right here from the radiator.
Well, there's no point in you standing there getting wet. Get out of the way. Let me see if I can do something.
Oh, I certainly hope you can.
Yes, it's a very old radiator.
Yeah, just like everything else in this hotel.
Yes.
Then what you run into over there?
Run into?
Yeah, you nearly knocked me over.
Oh, did I? Oh, I'm sorry. I was in a bit of a hurry. You know, I didn't see you.
Yes, you were.
When you turn it one way, it leaks. When you turn it the other way, it bends.
Well, we can't have banging all night, can we?
No. So I guess it'll just have to leak then.
Let it bend.
Okay, so there's no point in changing bed sheets.
No, I guess not.
So that's it then?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, we can use this one.
I beg your pardon?
I said we can use this bed.
That's what I thought you said, yes.
Don't you understand what I'm saying?
I think so, yes.
Well, then what are you waiting for?
Well, I don't know, really.
Have you done fiddling with the radiator?
Yes, I mean, there's not much I can do about it.
Oh, no, listen, if you can't do anything, just say so.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, I would.
Well, I would if I wanted to.
Oh, so you don't want to? Is that what you're saying?
I'm thinking about it.
You are thinking about it.
That's what I said, yes.
Oh, for God's sake, stop making excuses. If you can't do it, then get on with it.
All right, then.
What are you doing?
I'm taking my trousers off.
To mend the radiator?
No.
Then what for, then?
Well, my trousers are wet. They're soaking.
Put them on again.
No, but I wet my trousers. I mean, they're wet. Oh, you wouldn't do that. I was just going to bed.
Going to bed where?
Well, here or over there or anywhere. I would go after you'd finished or we'd finished. We haven't.
Are you mad?
No, I'm just awfully, awfully confused.
Now listen, I want to tell you again. Put your trousers on and get out of here.
But they're soaking. They're soaking wet. Have a feel. an awful mistake.
Oh, so you're not a plumber?
And I take it you're not...
Not a what?
Well, you thought this was your room.
But yeah, at least I thought it was my husband's room.
Well, that explains everything, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm most awfully sorry, whatever you must have thought of me.
Well, I thought you were a chambermaid.
Lying on the bed and telling you to get on with it.
I thought
you thought I was a whore.
Oh, no, 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 never. I know that, yes.
And cold makes it worse, usually.
Oh, I didn't know that, actually.
You have to take your trousers off.
Not again, thank you.
I'll take them off. They are soaking wet.
I'll take them off when you leave the room.
Oh, don't mind me. I was a nurse.
Oh, if you advise me on medical grounds. I beg your pardon.
Give them to me. I'll put them in the bathroom. Slightly warm in there. And then I'll have to get dressed and find my husband's room. Oh, what is wrong with this place?
Can't you find him anything?
Certainly I can.
If he's nice to me.
Nice to you? I apologize for everything. What more can I do?
Try a drink.
What?
Not for you, for him.
A drink? Yes, of course. Frank. Five francs here. Beyond that, I will not go. Well, I will go, but it won't be here.
Okay, follow me.
Yes, thank you. And as for you, you better be out of here when I come back, or I'll have you forcibly ejected.
Madame, this is friend!
Did you get the phone?
If you can see, no, you have to go as you are.
Yeah, right.
Go on, go.
What, like this?
Yes, go in the corridor and hide, and then come back as if you were just hiding.
In my dressing gown?
Yes, no, I mean, say you were in an accident in the hospital, and then you woke up with no memory of the accident, and then you came back here, and then
now you're talking college.
Yes, I am. Get back in the bathroom.
Oh, what good is that?
Well, so then I can get your clothes out.
Does this mean?
I don't know. Anyway, it's locked. Look, we didn't do anything. Why don't we just explain?
To Claude, you've seen what he's like. If he comes in here and finds me, and you like this, he'll kill us.
Yes. What do you have underneath?
Oh, nothing.
Nothing, nothing at all.
I was taking a shower.
Well, this is no good. Just get in the hall and then hide. Oh, no, he's here.
Back up.
You realize you have cost me 5 francs and a great deal of inconvenience.
Well, don't tell me. Complain to the manager.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm taking my trousers off. They're wet.
Well, it's no thanks to you that mine aren't. And look at this.
Are you some kind of hotel souvenir collector?
No, my dear friend. At my first pool, the handle came off the chain. At my second pool, the chain came off the cistern. At my third pool, the cistern came off the bloody wall.
And what do you want to do with that?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe I'll wrap it around someone's neck and strangle them with it.
There's no need for violence.
What? No violence? Why?
This is a very offensive weapon.
Well, it came from a very offensive place.
Get away from me, you maniac. Get away.
Come on. Why like that?
Oh, man. I am the High Constable of France.
Who the hell is that? Arrest this man for trespass.
Oh, no, it's merely for the peasant. Otherwise, I'm the hotel manager.
Is he the manager?
No, he's the bird of the bloody Alcatraz.
The hotel porter told me there had been some confusions over the booking.
Yes. Get this man and put him in the padded cell.
I'm afraid we do not have any padded cells, sir, in the hotel.
You must have some.
Look, shut up. The hotel porter booked me into this room, and I demand it immediately.
And I booked this gentleman in.
Then certainly you've made a mistake.
I do not make mistakes. I am the hotel manager.
Do you think you can treat a member of the British High Diplomatique like this?
British Court Diplomatique?
Well.
Oh, he can be. Look at him. Waving that chain around, is that the action of a man responsible for British policy?
It is the policy of Lady Britain to defend herself whenever attacked.
With lavatory chains?
It's just about all we have left nowadays.
Wait, gentlemen, wait. There is a solution to this if you both agree with
it. Let's hear it then.
Well, this is a family room with two double beds in it, and you're two gentlemen on your own.
I'm not on my own, I have a wife, remember?
Well, yes.
You should do.
Well, she's not here, is she?
What do you mean she's not here? She's in the bathroom.
You mean she has come back?
Obviously.
I was down in reception the whole time. I didn't see her come through.
She came the other way.
There's no other way.
Why? Why would I tell you that my wife is in the bathroom if she wasn't in the bathroom?
There's a difference. There's a big difference between having your wife and some other woman.
Now, all this is quite easily settled. We just go in and see.
No!
Yeah, let's go and see.
No!
Why not?
Because I don't want to!
Do you realize that for the immoral behavior, I can ask you to leave this hotel immediately?
Immoral behavior?
Me? Yes, sir, you.
And I am forgetting about your love story.
I'm sure there's no woman in the bathroom.
But aren't we going to go in and see?
No, I'm quite ready to take his word.
She hasn't given you one.
It's good enough for me. So, I think if you're ready to share the room?
No.
Certainly not. Then what about the woman in there? Are we sharing her?
paper as well.
I'm not sharing with him.
Nor I with that buffoon. Okay, there is one other solution to this. Toss up for it.
No!
Yes, why not?
No!
Why not?
Because I don't know why you would want to.
Well, it's two against one, so there. Heads! Tails!
Ha! You lost!
Yes, of course. And therefore, as a gentleman and a sportsman, I agree to share the room without any further hesitation.
But that's not what we tossed for.
Of course it is.
Oh, yeah, that's quite correct. The matter is now closed. There's a partition you can pull out. It makes two completely separate different rooms. You'll have your utter and complete privacy. Have a little bother with this.
Alright, now who have you got in that bathroom?
A personal friend.
Then get rid of her.
No, you don't really think that I'll bring her out in front of you like this?
Well, I don't know her, do I?
No, but it might embarrass her.
Well, she'll certainly embarrass me if she stays.
Why?
Well, you don't imagine I'm going to spend the night up here with you and some cheap whore you brought up.
She's not some cheap whore.
Well, certainly you know what you're paying her. But let me make it quite clear. I'm not participating in your primitive sex orgy.
You weren't invited. And you're not going to open that. It's closed.
What do you mean I'm not going to open it?
You know what? Supposing I...
Yes?
Supposing I told her to leave, will you give us 10 minutes?
Why 10 minutes?
Well, so that I can say goodbye to her.
Ew! You're a sexually deprived animal! You don't think I'm hanging around in the bathroom outside while you have a quick...
Oh, how dare you!
I shall give you 3 minutes.
3 minutes?
Yes. Long enough for a decent farewell, and not enough for an indecent one.
Make it 5.
3! And if I have any more, I shall make it 2.
He's a pompous, arrogant pig!
You are referring to my husband!
Yes, and if we don't hurry up, he'll be back!
Oh, listen, I know I'm sorry he's like that, but he can't stand anything immoral. He finds anything to do with sex distasteful.
Oh, it must be a lot of fun for you.
How dare you!
I'm sorry.
But I forgive you, but there are more things in life than sex, you know.
Well, yes, and one of them is getting you out of here. It's no good, you have to go in the bathroom again.
Oh, I'm not going back in that bathroom. I've already had 2 showers and a bath. What do you think, I'm a mermaid?
Well, no, but he's out there and you cannot go through the door.
The window.
What about it?
It's the only way out.
Oh, no. Please don't jump.
Oh, I wasn't going to. I mean, it's the only way out of the room.
But we're 2 stories up.
Well, that's nothing. We'll tie some sheets together and you'll have to lower me down.
But that's very dangerous.
Oh, don't worry about me. I've had lots of funny experience. If we only had some rope.
Rope?
Yeah, rope.
I have some rope. I bought some. Yes, it's a rope to throw myself out. You know, I bought it so I can get out of the pond. I drove into that pond to avoid being rammed by a lunatic in a Mercedes doing 90 miles an hour on the wrong side of the road. Well, he wasn't really on the wrong side of the road, I was. I mean, I'm British, so it takes time to get used to right-hand driving. But if we went to Blackpool, nothing of this would have happened. You know, you can sprain your wrist in Blackpool or trip, but...
Come here. Now you have to lower me. And don't worry, I shall be perfectly all right.
I'd rather you didn't.
Oh, you've been sweet, you really have.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you could have just walked out there and left me to cloud, but you didn't.
No, I couldn't, no.
Oh, no, listen. If we never meet again, thank you for everything. And now, you have to go with me.
Okay.
Oh, keep the rope taut. Oh, not so taut. Oh, slacken a little. Oh,
lower.
Okay, good. Now lower. Oh, lower.
Lower.
Yeah, lower. Oh, keep lowering.
Lower.
Yeah, keep lowering.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Ah, wait.
What happened?
My dressing gown.
What about it?
It got caught on the hook.
Well, what should I do?
I don't know, hold me up again.
I can't.
Come on now, open up, you catch up.
No, I need more time.
Hold me up.
I can't.
There is no more time.
asked me on the way down.
What are you doing?
What have you been doing with this woman and this rope? Are you some sort of sexual maniac?
No, but what are you doing?
She's somewhere here, dead or alive.
No, wait. She went through there.
Through where?
Through that door.
What wallpaper?
Wallpaper door. Yeah, she lives in there.
Well, why didn't you say so before?
Why should I tell you about my personal friend?
The radiator.
What about it?
What's it doing up there?
I don't know.
But it wasn't there before.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was. Look, if we're to share the room, we might as well get along together, you know? You know, I don't want to share a room with some complete stranger, so...
Well, then, if you're offering me a drink...
No. I'm taking this back to England. I'll buy you one.
Very well, then. Go and order some. Yes? Hello, you fool!
Yes.
We'd like some drinks. Yes, I know the bar is closed. Up here, you buffoon. Yes. I'd like a double scotch.
I'll have three.
Better bring the whole bottle. Yes, now. Come on, you man. Come on. Now, listen here, old chap. I know we're in France, but while we're here, no more ropes or radiators. Please!
Wait, that's my end.
What do you mean your end?
Well, yes, that's my end, you know.
But my suit is
I'll get it for you. It's easier this way.
What do you mean easier?
I'll be back in a second. Yes.
I say, you in there, the doors you jammed.
Well, get it open.
Serves you right. You shouldn't have bloody well gone in there.
Et voilà. And this finish of room service.
Hey, what are you doing? You there, close that window.
Is naked woman running down street.
What naked woman?
You don't think her? She's there.
Good thing my wife isn't here.
Your wife isn't here?
No, of course she's not.
Ah, so woman I'm showing up here belongs to other man.
Oh, it must be, because his girlfriend is in there, behind the wallpaper door.
But this is Mrs. Hofmeyer's room.
Well, if that's her name, what's she like?
I'm not seeing her, but I hear she's a Bulgarian lady doing things with bicycles.
Bicycles?
Yeah, manager is saying she'll bring good business to hotel.
I think she's already started.
So, where is your wife?
I don't know where my wife is.
Hello, darling.
Simone! Did you could make it?
I will explain in a moment, darling. Where is the bathroom?
It's through there.
Oh, what a lovely big room with two beds. Naughty, naughty, naughty.
So who is this lady?
Don't be silly, my dear fellow. That lady is my wife.
Not for 10 francs, she's not.
Take all of me. Baby, can't you see?
There's a bottle in it. his case in case he hasn't locked it.
Who?
That idiot they've put in here with us.
But where is he?
He's out looking at some naked woman running around in the woods.
What kind of an hotel is this?
The only one with a vacancy, darling.
That doesn't surprise me.
To us, my dear.
To us, darling. How is your wife?
My wife? She's perfectly fine, thank you.
Is she still called to you?
Yes, yes. In fact, at this very moment, she's colder than ever.
Why don't you divorce her?
No, darling, we've been through all this. I can't.
But you don't love her.
Well, yes and no. You see, she's awfully clean.
Clean?
Yes, awfully clean. The house is spotless, the furniture is spotless, even the garden is spotless.
Oh, really?
Yes, and I even swear she hoovers the damn little flower beds. And when it's time for bed, she looks at me with those clean blue eyes. And I feel absolutely filthy.
Yes, you go right off to cabarets and pick up girls like me, yes?
No, darling, that's not fair. I didn't pick you up. I met you. I only went in there on business.
Business?
Yes, you know what my business is.
Ah, so you came in there to sell us biscuits.
No, not you. The chap I was with, he's one of our best customers. He dragged me in there.
I'm going for a bath. And what the hell is that?
Yes, I know. He did it.
But how?
Well, he had a woman up in here, and I think they, well, did it between them.
Curious things, but with lady.
I think he's a bit kinky. Or perhaps she is, or perhaps they both are.
And where is she?
She's in the room next door, and her name is Mrs. Hofmeyer.
And why doesn't he go in there with her?
I don't know, darling. Perhaps he is in there.
Well, let's hope he stays in there. I don't want him in here with us.
I say, is that a nun's outfit?
Yes.
And do you wear that at your cabaret?
Yes, but not for long. I wear this underneath.
Oh, and are you putting it on?
My hat?
No, no, the underwear.
But I've just taken it off.
Pity.
You want me to put it on again for you, yes?
Well, only if you want to.
Oui?
Only if you want to.
You want a private performance?
Well, I haven't seen your new cabaret now, have I?
Well, it comes rather expensive.
But wait till you see what you're getting in return.
Can't I see it first?
I was hoping to save it for later.
Well, can you show it to me now?
Well, very well then. If you insist, here we are.
Is this it?
Why? What were you expecting?
I thought it might be another tin of biscuits.
Well.
Oh, darling. It must have cost a fortune.
Well, it was rather expensive.
Oh, darling. It's marvelous. It's cabaret.
Get right to the point. I don't pop my
into the pond and all the clothes got soaking wet.
Helga, you're hurt, are you?
Oh, no, no, I'm not hurt. I just had to take off all of my clothes. He said there's another man in here with you.
Another man? Yes, nasty piece of work, too. Let's say I did not know
Oh, no. I was visiting my sister, but as tonight is her birthday, I wanted to surprise you.
You certainly did.
Happy returns.
Yes, thank you. And now we shall be leaving right away to another room.
Another room? But why? You have this room.
No. We shall leave right away.
No, Claude. I'm cold. I must have a hot bath.
A hot bath? No, absolutely out of the question.
Why is it? Of course then we have a hot bath.
No, she cannot. Not in there.
Why not?
Yes, why not?
Because that other man's wife is in there.
You mean she has come back?
Obviously.
I would love to see her.
Oh, no, you don't.
I mean, when she comes out.
When she comes out, then we'll all see her.
Of course.
Then again, she might not be out for quite some time.
Why?
Because she's had a long day and she's soaking.
So is your wife. Perhaps we can ask her to hurry up?
No. Certainly, that's up to her husband. And her husband must go. There you are. We've been looking for you all day.
Oh, how are you?
Your wife is here.
Hello.
That's not my wife.
That's my wife, you idiot.
How do you do?
How do you do?
She has returned.
Yes, so I see. I didn't recognize her.
No, there is no reason why you should. We've never met before.
I didn't recognize her as a woman, that's what I mean.
Can you finish?
Yes, and I'm leaving.
Your wife has returned, and she is in the bathroom.
Brenda?
If that's her name.
Did she find her ring? Brenda!
It's all right, Brenda. Your husband is here, Brenda. And my wife is here, Brenda. Brenda. Because that's her name, isn't it? No point in standing on ceremony to share the room together.
What, the four of us?
No, we shall leave right away.
Not until I've had my bath.
I'll tell her to hurry up. Brenda!
It's okay, darling.
Darling?
Did I say darling?
I think your wife should have a bath immediately. This is my medical opinion.
Yes.
Nobody asked you for it.
Nevertheless, she should have a hot bath.
Well, then give her one.
You want me to bathe her?
No, we'll find her one. There must be other bathrooms in this rat trap.
I'm afraid they're all occupied.
What about you?
What about me?
Well, certainly you have a bath.
Of course I have a bath. I have a bath every day, besides even two.
Then what do you bathe in?
Hot water, naturally.
For heaven's sake.
Well, what do you expect me to bathe in? Essence milk, champagne? Really, I do not have to stand this abuse from you. I am the manager.
Then do you think that you could manage to let my wife borrow your bathroom?
Why didn't you ask me in the first place? They would think I'm some kind of an idiot.
Brenda!
This way, dear lady.
Think of God! We have had some kind of an explosion!
I merely sneezed!
Not that radiator! What is doing up there?
Ask the Marquis the sadism over there!
Well, it's been leaking all day! It's been leaking and banging, and I think it's on the flat ledge.
It's on the ceiling!
Well, of course, that's steam pressure.
Steam pressure?
Yes, the pressure of steam, it expands and the power is enormous. Well, yes, of course it could. I mean, steam pressure drives locomotives and airliners and spaceships. Why couldn't it drive a radiator up?
I have never heard
Don't
such rubbish.
Listen to it then.
Could I have my bath, please?
Of course. This way, dear lady.
Thank you.
You're taking a bit of a chance, aren't you?
Yes, I am. Wait, what do you mean?
Letting her go with him.
Well, he wouldn't try anything, would he?
He did with my wife.
Well, you might have warned me.
Brenda!
No. My wife is absolutely capable of taking care of herself.
She'll need you with him.
No. My wife is absolutely and completely respectable.
So was mine until she came here.
I wouldn't know that. I never met your wife.
Never met her? You keep calling her darling.
Oh, well. I'd better explain. You see, the Brenda in there is not your Brenda.
Well, who is she then?
A friend.
A friend of Brenda's?
A friend of mine.
Oh, I see.
No, it's all completely innocent.
You have a bird in there.
I have a lady in there. There's no need to be coarse or vulgar about it.
Oh, yes, let's not be coarse or vulgar about it. When I had a girl in here, you accused me of bringing some cheap whore here.
Well, I'm sure Mrs. Hoffmeyer is a perfectly respectable lady. Who? Mrs. Hoffmeyer, the Bulgarian lady from next door. Your friend with the bicycle tricks?
Oh, her! Yes, I only knew her by her first name.
And what's that?
Gladys. Yes.
Gladys Hoffmeyer from Bulgaria?
Yes, what about yours?
Oh, her name is Simone. Now look, old chap, I need your help.
Oh yes, and a fat load of help you gave me when I needed it. What was it you called me?
Let's not dwell on the past. The point is that we're both in a situation that can put us in a bad light.
Oh, you're not in a bad light, mate. You're floodlit. You're fully illuminated and it's showing you up for the merely mild hypocrite you are. And you want me to pretend that woman in there is my wife?
Well, it won't be for long. As soon as Helga is back, we shall both leave.
And I'll be here with Simone.
Oh, no, you won't, because she'll be leaving as well.
Oh, will she?
Yes, just think about it. You have the entire room to yourself. It'll be just you and Gladys. The ropes, the radiators, today.
No.
Come on, old chap. What is your name, by the way?
Stanley.
Stanley! Well, the manly name is Stanley. Love.
So will I be if Brenda comes back.
She never hears about Gladys Hoffmeyer.
I mean, she wouldn't. I mean, how would she?
Well, you know how people gossip, especially one's enemies.
I don't have any enemies.
Your wife needs some clothing.
Clothing?
Yes, a dress, underwear, the usual things ladies wear when they're naked.
We haven't got anything.
She says perhaps this gentleman might help.
I think I saw a lady's suitcase by the back door.
Yes, thank you. Oh, and about that other business with Gladys, I trust you'll be sensible.
Can I ask you a question?
How far?
far are we going?
Bed?
Oh, are we? Well, if I'm being blackmailed into it.
Oh, that's an ugly word.
I mean coerced, persuaded by threats.
Couldn't you just think of it as fun, baby?
No, I couldn't.
Why?
Well, you see, my conscience would make me feel very guilty.
Would it, baby?
Yes, if I thought of it as fun, but if I thought of it as a duty to preserve my marriage as a task to be fulfilled, then...
Well, try and look as if you are enjoying it, for Claude's sake.
But Claude won't be here, will he, when we...
Oh, it's for his benefit.
You know, I don't give benefit performances.
You wait. Tonight, I shall give the greatest show he has ever seen.
Oh, will you?
It will be the greatest performance of my career.
What is your career, by the way?
You'll find out soon enough, darling. You're going to be in the audience.
Audience?
Don't go away, my darling husband. I'm going to get dressed.
Dressed? Hardly seems necessary.
Now we're in trouble, Helga refuses to go, insists upon spending the night here.
And I've been here with Simone, and so does she.
Oh, does she?
Yes, you ask her.
Well, that's okay. I've spoken to the manager, and he's putting a campaign on the bathroom.
Who for?
You.
Me?
Yes, isn't that obvious?
Not for me, it isn't. I started here with a large room and 2 double beds in it. Then I have a room with 1 double bed in it. Now you're telling me I have to sleep in the bathroom on a combat. Before the night is over, I'll be on the roof in a bloody hammock.
Don't be so awkward, dear boy.
Awkward? I'm fighting for my very existence here. With lying and thieving and you and her. And you've opened my brandy. I'm supposed to be on a holiday.
Don't get hysterical. If we both pull together, we shall both get out of it.
Well, I'm not the one in it. You're the one in it.
Aren't you forgetting about Gladys Hoffmeyer?
Oh, to hell with Gladys Hoffmeyer!
It's a little too late for that, Stanley, my boy. United we stand, divided we fall. And you're sleeping in a bathroom.
And where are you sleeping? Or I intend you on making a tour?
That is no concern of yours.
It should be. She's supposed to be my wife.
Well, then you sleep in separate beds. There's nothing strange about that. Helga and I do.
Well, Simone and I don't.
Simone?
Yes.
You don't think she wants you in bed with her, do you? What, dear?
Who doesn't want who in bed with who?
His wife, Brenda, doesn't want him in bed with her.
Oh, and why is that?
That's no business of ours, darling.
Well, you seem to be discussing this, I mean, why?
He, has a rash. Yes, he was just showing it to me. I don't like them.
I don't know, you ask him.
Oh, how would you know? Mind,
oh, certainly he would, darling.
Oh, dear, you seem to forget that I was for 2 years in the skin hospital and for 5 years in the fever hospital and then for 2 years in that hospital where I met you.
Oh, what was wrong with him?
And a little trouble with my... You mind your own business.
Well, this is as much my business as my rash is your business.
Oh, but his was not infectious and yours might be.
No, it's not.
Oh, do you know, after all, we're sharing the room.
No, we're not sharing the room. He's sleeping in the bathroom.
In any case, I think I should see it. Where is it?
It's not very handy.
Where is it?
Oh, it's on his stomach.
Well, just let me look at it.
No.
Just lift up your shirt.
It's on the move.
Look at it.
Look at what, madame?
I was just asking your husband if I... could see his...
Well, really, do you think he's showing it to everyone?
Now. My wife meant well. After all, it was her profession.
Well, you know a profession better than I do, monsieur.
No, it's true. She was a nurse.
Oh, was she, darling? Yeah. Well, I think as your wife, I should be the one to see it.
Back in a second.
Well, poor man.
Poor man? What do you mean, poor man?
Married to a woman like her, and he seems so nice.
Nice? He's not nice, he's revolting.
Oh, how do you know?
I've been up here all night with him. You don't know? He's a complete degenerate.
He's very nice to me. Did you see, madame?
Yes, and I assure you, it's nothing to worry about.
Well, was it inflamed?
I don't know what you mean.
I mean, was it angry looking?
No, it seemed quite...
Ha ha ha!
my wife. That lady is his wife.
Oh. I make a mistake. Excuse me.
No problem.
What is happening to radiator? Does Madame know?
How would she know? She wasn't here.
What are you saying she wasn't here?
She means I was not here.
But I'm showing you up here to room, we are talking.
Oh, talking?
We were talking on the stairs. You see, I got lost on my way down from the manager's platform.
But how was it he was showing you up if you were going down?
I went down too far, and he had to show me my way up again.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and we were talking and... he was telling me about how he lost his herd.
His herd?
Reindeer? Yeah, and told him they would help him to buy him some more reindeer.
I see. Yeah.
So, you are pleased giving contribution to reindeer fund.
I have a strong feeling I contributed earlier.
But your wife is nice, kind lady. It is much nicer than other men's.
Oh, very well. Here's 10 francs.
10 francs is not buying great strong reindeer.
It's buying a small, sickly one. Feed it up.
Your wife is promising 50 francs.
50 francs?
Is very kind lady this much nicer than other men?
Oh, fine. Here you are.
Thank you very much, monsieur. Merci bien, madame.
Really, darling, I don't understand. Why did you have to promise him 50 francs?
Well, I felt so sorry for him. All of his reindeer died.
For the porter, not! Father Christmas, what does he need reindeer for?
Among my peoples, reindeer is way of life. We are eating reindeer. We are milking reindeer.
Just where the hell are you from?
Mexico.
There aren't any reindeer in Mexico.
I know this, senor, and it is exactly why I'm saving money to buy some. It's not just...
Really, darling, I don't understand. Why did you have to promise him 50 francs?
Well, darling, let's not argue. After all, it's your birthday.
But I was beginning to think it was his birthday. Do you know how many biscuits I had to sell for that? Conference? What conference?
Well, you came here for a conference, no?
Oh, that conference, yes. We conferred as one does at a conference, you know?
Yes. Do you know that this is your fourth conference in the past 3 weeks? Don't you ever decide anything?
We decided to have another one next Friday. But say, would you care to go out for a drink?
Oh, go out, but couldn't we have a drink up here?
But there's no room service.
Oh, but... I don't want to go out. I want to stay here with you.
All right, but what are we going to do?
We'll do what we always do. Have a nice game of cards.
Why did you run off and leave me just when we opened the bar again?
Well, you see, that man in there was the manager. He knows my wife.
He wasn't even looking at us. He was arguing with those men. Who were they?
Oh, those were the men he sent to the hospital.
But there didn't seem anything wrong with them.
Well, that's why the man was trying to hit him.
Well, we can't go out. We might as well go to bed.
What, now?
Why not, darling? It's cabaret time.
Memories of love.
Before we turn it, it relaxes us.
Well, we don't need relaxing. relaxing you.
No, we have our own way of relaxing.
Must you have the radio on?
Yes.
We always undress the music, don't we, darling?
Yes.
Stop it!
Stop what?
Stop everything! My wife has a headache.
Oh, really, Claude?
Well, it's disgusting, darling. I told him to stop.
What they do is their business. They're married.
But we're married as well, and we don't go on like that.
It's none of your business what they do.
But they're in the same room.
No, they're not. They're in the room next door.
But there's only this partition.
Come out of it.
Incredible.
Aren't you getting undressed?
No, I can't compete with you.
Oh. Come on, let me see you try.
No.
Come on, I'll help you.
No.
Come on, I can give you an audition. You can then earn lots of money.
I don't want to earn lots of money anywhere.
Oh, come on, darling. Tease me a little. You can't go to bed with your clothes on. One thing. I made a promise to myself. After tonight, no more married men.
Well, yes, that's after. Afterwards, I think you should, but not now.
And what about your wife?
Well, she won't be back.
I think this is very disrespectful. Having to share the room with the other people.
It's not good blaming me. It's not my fault.
Where is my husband?
He's probably in village watching the fireworks. I'm showing you up here with Maniac losing hotel.
Maniac?
Yeah, Maniac is attacking Mrs. Hofmeyer. Don't worry, police are looking for you. Meet dogs.
Girlfriend. Oh. Then whose girlfriend is she?
Nobody.
You won't even get a chance to talk to them. Perhaps those dogs will get you first, yeah?
I know.
Well, then talk.
Okay, I'll talk. I'll start with you getting out of that window.
That has nothing to do
with it. It has everything to do with it. That's how it all started. That's why the dogs were after me. That's why they set fire to me.
Well, you're lucky to be alive in that.
And then Mrs. Hofmeyer recognized.
She recognized you.
She chased me down with her bicycle pump down the fire escape.
Oh. The first thing to do in this case is to get rid of your clothes.
I beg your pardon?
No, your trousers.
But I have nothing underneath.
Oh, then after with me. Into bed, quick, sharp.
Simone?
She's Claude's girlfriend, isn't she?
No.
Why are you protecting him?
I don't know. I mean, he said that he'll tell Brenda about Gladys.
Gladys? Oh, who's Gladys?
You are.
I am?
Yes. When you were hiding in the bathroom and Claude came, I told him that I had a girlfriend in here named Gladys.
Oh, I see. So you did all this to protect me?
Helga, I'm sorry I was cross, Helga.
I'm sorry I was cross with you just now.
Oh, well, it's all right. You weren't too long.
You know, you're really a marvelous person. No other man has ever done things like this for me before.
Well,
for you, I would do anything.
Just
anything you ask for.
Just don't tell Brenda and keep Claude quiet.
Oh, Claude. Now when I think of Claude.
Be quiet or the dogs will be again.
Oh, don't go, it's not English. They don't allow dogs in the hotels.
Good. Do the dogs know?
Two-faced, sanctimonious hypocrite. I will kill him.
Good. Do that. But wait till you get home. Then you can do it quietly.
Do it quietly.
Well, poison him or suffocate him or anything.
Oh, no. What is sauce for the gander is sauce for the goose.
Goose him? Oh, okay, yeah, just don't do it here.
I am going to do it up here, and you are going to help me.
Am I?
Yes. Oh, don't you want to?
I do.
Very good.
Want to help you?
Good.
But I think I can.
Oh, and why is that? Have you been helping somebody else?
No.
No little French charities over there on?
No.
Are you sure?
Positive.
You know, Claude says, I'm not very sexy.
He must be raving mad.
I was watching Simone getting ready for bed. Yeah? I don't like her, but perhaps I got some things from her.
Oh, yes, you've cottoned on very sharpish.
Are you comfy?
Yes, very much.
Do you remember that time when you thought I was a chambermaid mate?
Yes.
Do you still feel the same way about me?
Yes, but...
But what?
Well, we ought to stop and think.
Oh, I've thought about this for ages. But with Claude, this is as far as it gets.
Oh, but...
but
my wife isn't there.
Oh. Oh, so she is. I'm so sorry. I have forgotten. I'm sorry.
No, it's all right.
Oh, but...
How long have you?
10.
9 and 10. We've been married for 19 years.
Just seen non-meat purple!
Do you mean this?
What?
with you in England?
Live with you, I insist.
Congratulations, my dear fellow.
Danny, can help me do out the
family. I knew it.
Give me what?
I knew we should have never come here.
To my new family. Nazdrav.